if you hear a buzzing on this video, it's because this bee is really loud. Do you mind?
That was to the bee, not you. I mean, I'm sure you mind. Anyway, I suppose we need bees. This is Sunday Outside, where I read everyone's comments, or I used to, but they obviously get so many comments now. Did I just say views instead of comments? You know what I mean. Anyway, let's get rid of some of your comments. Let's start from last Sunday. Yorkshire Bus Guys put, looked like a gorgeous afternoon there. Not a fan of the hot weather or sunbathing, but I do like to see a nice park on a bright sunny day. The late mornings and longer evenings are a blessing too. Not sure you'd agree though, Charlie. Absolutely not. I'm so glad right now it's clouded over. It was really hot and sunny today, but it's been a bit rainy as well at the same time. At exactly the same time. Buddhazee's Revenge has put, I went back and listened to Andrew Wynne's evidence. Oh dear, very damning for the others that came after him. Especially the likes of Ismay. And yes, you're right, the scandal goes fathoms deep. I think it's way more than the sub-postmasters. As bad as it is, obviously, for them. I think money's probably been laundered. I think that maybe government money and post office money that has just been siphoned out and been used for who knows what purposes. I think it goes that far, and who knows how far it goes. UK Davis put, green spider, microbot engineered, Charlie's nose believed to be controlled by Paul. Can you imagine if Paul tried suing me or something? Good luck with that, I've got nothing. There's nothing more dangerous than somebody who's got nothing to lose. Is that bee just going around me now? Are you after a cameo or something? Do you know what I mean? Do you want my autograph or something? Do you want me to move? Is that what it is? Am I disturbing your nectar gathering? You know what I mean? Get a nectar card. It's just gone off. Yeah, I read everyone's comments because I think it's nice that people know that the comments have been read. And Joe87's put, on Bank Holiday Monday, can you do a video where you look at the TV guide and see if there's anything different? I am going to be so busy next week. I'm going to try uploading 2 videos a day on Paula Vennells to catch up. Buddhazee's Revenge put, hey, can you do a game of snakes and ladders? Maybe not. At most of witnesses could be skidding down the snake. Tangled Charlotte's put, I'm on team interrupting. This is because when I'm doing the videos on the post office scandal, I used to comment, and then people didn't like that. And then I used subtitles instead, captions, and then obviously there's people who don't like that. But then I'm doing the videos anyway, because I'm glad that people are interested in the inquiry. But when you watch the full live inquiry, there's lots and lots of dead space time where nothing is happening, where documents are just getting pulled up. And some of these can last 30 to 40 to 50, and sometimes I think it's took more than a minute to pull a document up, and people just don't have the time to watch that. And it's not because they're not interested in the inquiry, it's because time and data is money. What I mean, UK has put, coffee is pronounced coffee. It comes from YouTubers being given a small amount from their viewers as appreciation enough to buy a coffee, hence coffee. Oh, right, I get it now. I get it. The Gadget Show used to compare cheap products to expensive ones all the time. It used to really annoy me when a £100 tablet by battling against a £1,000 iPad was slated for not being good. This would happen in about every episode. That is stupid. That is stupid. I mean, if something's cheap, it's obviously not going to have enough memory or battery power or whatever, is it? Shane Ollis, but I hate pretentious people, especially with phones. The thing is, you're damned if you do and don't. You don't get the latest iPhone 15 and say one would say, don't get that one, get the new one in September, or get an Android. I do cringe when people complain about the bezels on phones, as I said last week, and they talk about it like it's a Nokia from 1996. It is pretentious and cringe in my view. As Sherlock said last week, new isn't always better, and older phones can be almost as good as new ones. And I, in my view, have more character. I was very, very nearly going to get an LG phone because, all right, LG phones wasn't very popular at all, but they did have really good features. And then LG stopped making mobile phones. They pulled out of the phone market altogether. Let's get to Paula Vennells' comments. The first video I did was in preparation, getting ready, waiting for it to come on, because obviously we didn't know if it was going to be Jason Beer. We didn't know who was going to be answering questions. We know all of this now because she's given a 3 days testimony to the inquiry, but the build-up was just immense. In the words of Gene Wilder in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, the suspension was terrible. I hope it'll last. UK Dave has put... because this is about the bingo as well. I've got the bingo thing going on, haven't I? UK Dave has put, well, you can knock me down with a feather. She has appeared in person. I know, I was shocked. If she'd appeared by a flipping satellite link or something. I'm watching now. Loved it when Jason Beer asked if she thought she was the unluckiest CEO in the country. It was so good, wasn't it? Just straight in there. Chris Modlin has put, no doubt enough time to work out lies to cover herself. Absolutely. I mean, it was obvious in the inquiry that she'd been watching other people, particularly Susan Crichton, because obviously she was being used a bit of a scapegoat by Paula Vennells, especially the horribleness as well of being left outside of the boardroom when Susan Crichton wanted to highlight the issues. It was so bad. I mean, how horrible to be left outside. You was meant to be given a talk about the information that you knew, then you was just told, oh, you're not needed now, after hours being sat outside. FGFR Simon has put, oh, I'm ready, all right. The forecast is for rain all day, so bring it on. I know she has already tried last-minute document bombing the inquiry, but ITV News has trumped her with some very incriminating recordings and emails. A 766-page witness statement Paula Vennells wrote for the inquiry, and there was still loads of gaps in it. And it was just going on and on and on and on and on, but it was mainly just saying it wasn't me as judge. It should be a judge, really, shouldn't he? But as Jason Beer KC said, it was just all about deflecting. And the only time she had memory was when she could blame it somebody else. You know, if she could blame Susan Crichton, she would. If she could blame Alice Perkins, she would. Absolutely. I mean, I don't know what she was playing at. I mean, did she really think she was going to get away with it? She was clearly watching the inquiry. Did she not know who Jason Beer was? Tangled Charlotte has put, hey, I'm up for getting up at 5 a.m. over here to watch in real time. Oh, where are you from? I have coffee all set up. I have just punched the button. Don't think I'll do the same on Thursday and Friday, but I'll have to see the start. I'm editing this. After this morning, who needs sleep? I'm getting up all week. At least I have time to work in the afternoons. Well, that's just why I like editing the videos, because loads of people are interested, but they don't have time to wait around whilst the document's being pulled up or repetition. And it is difficult. It takes such a long time. It takes about 8 hours to do one video. A few more comments, because I can't read them all, and I'd love to read them all, but there's just not enough time, and it defeats the purpose, doesn't it, if you want to. So, Michael Enright has put, how evasive will she be? Hopefully, police prosecute her soon after this. Exactly. She's been to the inquiry. It's been a couple of days now. Where is the legal proceedings against her? Jane Smith has put, Charlie, you are just superb. Enjoy all of your videos. Thank you very much. Andy Fanshot has put, going to get my Jason Beer t-shirt on and a cup of coffee. That's brilliant. And one more comment then on this one. UK Davis, but I think we will witness more from Paul amnesia if she appears, that is. Oh, she was, wasn't she? She was just ridiculous. I can't recall, don't know, just like all the rest of them. So that was the pre-video, and then there's three videos. I've got so much work to do. Anyway, she did turn up, and she turned up looking ridiculous in that top she was wearing, that weird grey coat thing. And she did the tears, didn't she, three times on day one. And it's just like, too much. And we can see it's fake. There was no tears. That tissue was dry. Oh, ridiculous woman. Anyway, lots of comments. So many comments. I'm so glad everyone's still really interested in this. Twin wrote, as has put, best question of the day, so Wyn. Your brief was defensive, circumspect, carefully worded and guarded. Why? Not enough. I don't say enough about Sir Wyn Williams. He's really good as well, getting questions out and really stumping some of these witnesses, because the witnesses are just so stupid. It feels like I've wasted my life in retail. 25 years I've worked since 2000 in loads of retail, hospitality. I've done it all. Loads of customer facing stuff. I could have just been paid flipping tens of thousands of pounds a year working for the post office. If they're all that thick, I suppose I could have been flipping owner of the lot of them. You know, it's ridiculous. Oh, Neild has put, this woman is unbelievable. I love the slight look of amusement on the faces of Sir Wyn and Jason Beer as they started. Sir Wyn looks positively jolly. Everyone has been waiting for this. Absolutely. I mean, obviously we didn't get to see Miss Page do comments, which was unfortunate, but she did still have the death stare on Vennells. And obviously Jason Beer is really good at giving great angry sad eye. I even used it for one of the thumbnail pictures. Sir Wyn is really good at doing that like nonplussed face. I mean, you can tell because it's not a trial, it's an inquiry. All right, the witnesses are making ridiculous fools of themselves, but at the same time the question can be more stronger because there's not somebody able really to say objection, Your Honor, and this sort and the other. It's great. Even though they've got solicitors, I think even the solicitors for the witnesses are saying, well, actually, I'm not going to object because it involves all of us. It's owned, the post office is owned by all of us. Claire Davis has put, she did know. My pal works for James Arbuthnot and she said that PV and others looked at us in the eyes and lied. Of course they did. Of course they did. She's walked away with their millions. The CBE thing was just a joke. Tito Lauren has put, thank you for making these videos, Charlie, you're a star. Thank you, sir, are you for watching and keeping interested in the inquiry. And it's really good to know because the mainstream media are still doing a naff job. All they do is picking up tiny little bits, putting it on YouTube. And then they think they've done something and they could have sent in, I've said it so many times, they could have sent an investigative journalist, investigative whatever, undercover, decades ago and solved all this. If it had been the textile industry, the catering industry, the food industry, any other industry, how many times do we see that somebody from some newspaper or TV organisation sent somebody in undercover? And the post office seems to be so thick, they could have sent somebody in dressed in a clown outfit and post office would have battered an eyelid. A few more comments. There's so many comments. I really wish we had time to read them all and for you to stay and listen to them all because they're all so good. Tim Girl has put, keep doing what you're doing, Charlie. Thank you very much. Bodicine Revenge has put, and she still tries to control the narrative. It's weird. She's gone. She's left. And it just shows that it was her who was involved in it. Rainbow Playroom says, but Charlie, I'm obsessed. You need a TV show, podcast, the whole shebang. Charlie Fleming for Prime Minister. Thanks very much. I wouldn't want to be Prime Minister. I would love to be London Mayor. Because I would actually stay in my own lane, unlike the current mayor we have. I can't believe he got back in. Anyway, that's a whole different other bowl of wax. Because my biggest things, I'd get rid of things that I wouldn't be able to get rid of it. But I would put harsher penalties on people who do fly tipping. I'd put a lot more into city beautification, because London is nice. And it's unfortunate that outside of London, people have negative views of it. Oh, it's dirty and it's crammy. I'd be big on crime as well. I mean, what may wouldn't be? Well, you know, but anyway, yes. But that sort of rambling there was almost like a flipping POL flipping witness, wasn't it? Just kicked the camera then. Sorry if that jarred you. Neil Morrison has put 2 points. She still thinks she has a career. I know. She's like a politician. Can talk for minutes without answering a question. The ability of these people to be able to speak without saying anything is frustrating. And Tim Girl has put, it seems there is always better options, but robust choices were made. A few more comments on this one. Mike Ellis has put, ignorance is their excuse again and again and again. And Earth3 Lewis has put, she dresses like Atlanta Shaw from Stingray, from those old enough to remember the puppet series. Isn't it like Thunderbirds or something, or the other one? Thunderbirds. Oh, what were they called? The puppets, not Thunderbirds. And where are the Thunderbirds? What's a Thunderbird? It is Thunderbirds, isn't it? I was getting confused with Ladybirds and Thundercats for a second. I'll blame the bee. Oh, it's gone now, so I can't blame the bee. Who would post office blame? And user ML4JK4TR3B I suppose, had to stop watching this. She was putting me to sleep. She is either a woefully inept CEO or she's a liar. It is a difficult watch, though, isn't it, when someone's just been so pushbacky and whatnot. It is difficult to watch. Gina McGregor has put, oh my God, this woman makes me so mad. She really isn't she? And, I mean, let's go on something that's not been mentioned yet. Let's take the feminist issue, okay? How many times did you hear about the glass ceiling? How many times did you hear about women not being able to get far in the business? And then you get somebody like Paula Vennells. And not one dicky bear has been mentioned about that. Have you noticed? If the boot was on the other foot, there's actually loads and loads of women who have done really, really well at the post office. And where's all the screaming, like, aggressive feminists about glass ceiling, this, that and the other, and saying, oh, but, okay. Well, post office, you know, actually, when it comes down to it, humans are humans. And unfortunately, some businesses are run so terribly, illegally or badly, whatever it takes. It's not about gender. Business is business. And unfortunately, if you get a bad business with bad leaders, it doesn't matter what you are. It really doesn't. Let's go to the next one, part two. I can't tell how good it feels that everyone is just so interested in making sure that we know about what's going on at post office. These sub-postmasters, finally, after 2.5 decades, are getting exactly what they wanted, and that's to show these people up for what they are. Poppycat has put, when you listen to the cold-hearted liar, she is not crying about Martin Griffiths and his family. She's crying about the friend of hers. My thoughts are with Mr. Griffiths and not with hers. We're not. Absolutely. This was a really strong part because it was talking about Martin Griffiths, who allegedly built up a debt of something like £60,000 or something because of the dodgy Horizon system owned by Fujitsu, run by Fujitsu, made by Fujitsu. And post office was like not wanting to, was going to the contract saying, oh, you've got to pay this money back that wasn't even missing. And then he gets robbed and injured in an armed robbery. And then he's told by post office, oh, well, you did this, that, and the other, you've got to pay it back. They actually had no proof of what went on at that robbery. They don't know what happened. You know what? And so what if he had all the doors and the windows and everything open? You've already flipping accused him of taking £60,000. What difference did another few thousand pounds make? You broke the bloke. And then he met his terrible demise because of what they did to him. I mean, for crying out loud, if you was told, and you know you didn't owe that kind of money, £60,000, and then you're on the hook for another thing, I mean, who cares? You know what I mean? I mean, I'm not justifying what happened, obviously, but it's just that the people at the post office were so thick, stupid, nasty, inept, all of it. Whatever words there is in the thesaurus and dictionary is post office. They've completely destroyed the brand that they were so eager to protect. And then when Paula Vennells started crying, it was only because of the friend that she lost. It's nothing to do with Martin Griffiths. Because she only started crying when she was thinking about, I've been personally affected. It's just like, she's a real piece of work. Matt Sturgis has put, question that needed answering. Where did the missing money go? Who scripted You Are the Only One? Who scripted Plead Guilty for False Accounting when isn't? Well, this has all been, that's what's all been coming out. And so everyone, Paula Vennells, Janelle Singh, Roddy Smith, they all need to be taken in for questioning. But the thing that is, I've said it myself about prison time, they actually need to have money to be taken from them. Money that they was given in bonuses and their pensions, what they've got. Because if they go to prison, they're not going to go to Wormwood Scrubs, okay? They're going to be going to some flipping open prison for a couple of days and then put on tag. Their lives will not be affected at all by prison time. At all. It's not the same prison all these sub-postmasters went to. Not the same prisons at all. It's not even going to be Category C prison for any of them. They'll be let out on tag and it won't affect their life at all. They need to have money taken from them. I've forgotten the sub-postmaster's name now, but one of them went to prison. He said, hit them in the pockets. Absolutely, they need money to be taken off of them. There's no point sending them to prison, even though I've said it myself. It's just because of the frustration, isn't it? You want it because in your head you're thinking they're going to go to a mean, horrible place where they'll get absolutely what they deserve, you know? But they're not. That will not happen. They need money to be taken from them. Oh, as well, yeah, Jason V had stopped her. No one was buying the tears. No one was like, oh, do you want a drink of water? There's some tissues on the table there for you. Jason B just looked at his desk and went, waited for the tears to stop, as did the chair, Sir Wyn Williams. Everyone in the room's just not caring about her tears because the sub-postmaster's went through way more than what she did, especially when she started crying about the friend or the personal experience she had with it. When that's when she brought tears, not with Martin Griffiths. Reminded me of saying that. Oh yeah, that was Michael Enright said, Jason B are stopping and making a scene. Exactly. And then the recovery afterwards. It was instant almost. Which was like, she did this, wouldn't she? It looks so big. And then she tried looking up a few times, hoping if she keeps her eyes open, her tears would well up. They didn't know. Her own tear ducts don't even like Paula Vennells. that's how much she's hated. Lord of the Geeks has put, she must have an incredible brand of makeup. Haven't seen this waterproof since Amber Heard's crying on the stand. It'll make one hell of an advert. New ultimate waterproof mascara. No matter how tragic the story you're recounting, as applied to appear human, nor how real the emotions are, guaranteed never to run. Exactly. Them Kleenex tissues must have been so super absorbent and rehealing because they didn't get wet at all, did they? Gary Bowman has put, she's been nominated for the 2024 Matt Hancock Is Anyone Actually Fooled by My Pathetic Attempt at Pretending to Cry on Live TV Award. She is currently, I had no reason to say that, currently on the top step of the podium, gold medal position. Okay, she didn't run away like dopey Elaine. Oh, when Elaine Page ran off the flipping link. That's one of the reasons why I didn't want Paula Vennells on a link, because I bet Paula Vennells would have flipping tottered off somewhere until she was told to sit back down. She's a much slicker liar here. What the F word was with her face yesterday. She looked like she'd been in a tanning booth and forgotten to take a gas mask off. Right. The paler skinned you are, and if it happens to you, you can go a lot blotchy when you're under stress. I'm really pale. So if I'm under stress and I'm thinking about something, it doesn't mean that you're lying, but if you're just really trying to come up with an answer, if you're really thinking off, you're really stressed, you go blotchy. And the paler you are, the more noticeable it is. And I've got the skin of a redhead. So I go blotchy. I'm really thinking about something, or if I'm really nervous or something, apart from the sweating under my arms and getting swercles. But with her putting that big coat on and scarf, it was covering up most of her décolletage and neck. But I think it was still coming out in her face. And it did look as if she was obviously under stress because she's lying. Allegedly. I don't think Paula Vennells is watching this or any of her legal representatives. If they are, sod off. You know, give your money back that you stole. Well, it's theft, isn't it? I mean, I'm not the only person who said that. Even that, what's his lot bloke, he said it. Greg Jarvis has put, talk about incompetent, it beggars belief how she even got to this level. Exactly. I mean, was she put there because they already knew she was so stupid? And she was so stupid and gullible, she could continue it on because she, in her head... Well, I don't know. I mean, what could possibly be going on in her head? Don't forget she was flipping... high up in the church, wasn't she? I mean, that means anything. I've got past experiences of people being all holier than thou than turning out to be terrible, horrible, nasty people. I know that already. I've had a few decades of that experience, let me tell you that. So, you know, don't let people... And then someone said on a comment a couple of years ago, they said about religion, the last resort of a criminal. You know, they'll come say, oh... to God and this, that and the other, whatever God it is. And it's true, and I mean, Janelle Singh even picked up whatever religious artifact he had to wave into Jason Beer's face to say, look, I'm telling you the truth. And I found that, as I said last Sunday, so disrespectful to use your religious jewellery, religious artifacts, religious mumbo jumbo as a weapon or as a shield to prove that you're more honest than everybody else because you live in a book. Okay, I'm atheist, all right, whatever. But I still find it offensive. And I think anyone who does that, there's something wrong with you. As soon as anyone does that, it's the same thing really as when someone says, when they're in a lot of trouble, and they say, well, to be honest with you, it's like, well, I want you to be honest, you know? And sometimes you'll say it again, you know, you'll say it as just a filler word. But in certain situations, it's not a good thing to say, well, to be honest with you, like on Judge Judy, she picks people up on that. Just, no, don't use your religious stuff as a weapon or a shield or some sort of proof of your legitimacy in what you're saying. Absolutely makes me think the opposite and think, well, hang on a minute. You're expecting me to listen to you by using something I can't even see, you know, your religion, your God, whatever it is, to believe what you're saying. Makes no sense. Anyway, Royboy50 has put, JB's face is a picture. He's not fooled by this cold-hearted vicar, indeed. Absolutely. Absolutely. Dadangus has put, she has practised and practised her frill pies with her legal team and would be told to cry at this point. Great acting on a vile, deceitful woman who couldn't turn on the tears when she thought about a friend but never her victims. Exactly. Cam7522 was put, the common theme from post office witnesses is that only remembered and put in writing the good news. It has to have been deliberate. Yes, Paula Vennells did go on a bit of a tangent saying that I should made things better for the post office and this, that and the other, what she'd done. It's just like, no one cares if you've done a tiny little bit of good. Nobody cares that you saved maybe a few hundred post offices or, you know, transformed part of the business. If part of that you consider people ending lives and being made to pay back tens and hundreds of thousands of pounds they didn't even owe and losing their livelihoods as collateral damage. No. All that's going to make people think is, was all that money used to make the company better, to turn a profit? Because if you add it up, at the very minimum, I think it's something like millions of pounds. Obviously, like, tens of millions of pounds they made off of these poor people. Absolutely. Anyway, moving on.
Sorry, it's my nose isn't running. It's just really tickling and itchy.
Because it's been really, really, really sunny, and then it rained, and really, really sunny and rained, and keeps doing it over and over again. It's just causing all the pollens and everything, and it's getting right to the back of my nose. Like hay fever, I suppose. Hay fever. And yeah, this is part three of the Paula Vennells videos that I did. There's so much work I've got to get through next week. Truth Seeker has put, I am in complete awe of Jason Beer. What size is that man's brain? How does it even possibly how can it be even humanly possible to hold that much information in your brain and still present it in a cohesive and orderly fashion? By the end of this, it will be Sir Jason Beer, and his honour will be redistributed to him. Her great name is Bravo, Mr. Beer. Yes, it really is brilliant. I mean, when he was talking to Paula Vennells and he went through all the parts where she was like rebutting what people, her blaming it, I would absolutely trust that he'd read every single page of her witness statement. I really do, because he's just so good at showing these people up for what they are. I mean, if he'd not done the work, you can tell, can't you? It's just really, really good. John Dewever has put, she's nasty, knowingly pouring so much misery onto so many. She's sick. She is. She's sick. And Yaffle66 has put, she's gaslighting everyone. It's disgusting. Brain Wetten has put, When will she be prosecuted for criminal negligence caused by death and suicide? Absolutely, but like I've said in the previous bit, it's just that, she's not going to be sent to a prison that we want them to. She's not going to be put in with the complete and scary people and scared. They're just going to be let out on tag. They need financial punishment. That's what they need. Elaine Thompson has put, the book stops with her, end of. Yeah. Paula Vennells, and obviously still as well, Roddy's May. And even Elaine Cotton. I mean, she's just as flipping ridiculous. She should have some sort of punishment out of all this. She was the area manager of one of the SPMs who got prosecuted. And she didn't even know how to work the Horizon system. And she said she couldn't remember anything at all. And then there's one bit, and it really bugged me that I accidentally edited it out. But she still remembered which part of the management book that the SPM contravened. And the number of it, like that. And it's just like, okay, you just said you couldn't remember anything and you've remembered which part of the contract subsection and the number that the sub-postmaster contravened. That is some really weird stuff. Now the brain does remember some weird stuff, but only when it's done over and over and over again. For instance, I can still remember the catalogue number for a square 9-volt Energizer battery from Argos. And I quit Argos way back in 2002, I think it was, 2003 maybe. And it was 980-0971. I think that's the number. I still remember that number. I still remember my staff number from Argos, 612-5879. And I remember those numbers because I had to do that staff number for so many shifts, and I know the catalogue number for that square battery because it was the cheapest square battery that Argos sold. And I'd probably be putting that number into a till probably about 20 times a day. So that sticks in. But for some reason, Elaine Cotton can remember which part of a contract was contravened once. Didn't make sense. She knew more than what she was letting on. Absolutely. They all did. And we all know this. Because no group of people can be that thick and get into the positions that they was in. Yes, stupidity can be promoted beyond their ability, but you got to have some sort of brain power. Just an Aussie has put the way she is throwing everyone under the bus, she will be the CEO of public transport next. Unlimited buses to throw people under. She's absolutely awful. I mean, oh god, it's a terrible pun though, I know. But I think we've already all got there. People did actually die that way. She's actually done it. There needs to be some sort of prosecution over this. Peter Edwards has put, the incompetence of Vennells and the others is absolutely breathtaking. The scheme to cover the incompetence is an outrage, real or not. Her tears are nothing compared to the tears shed by SPMs and their families. Exactly. And then there's obviously the government side of it. It was with this hands-off approach. Did they just let go, you know? Because I'm pretty much sure that they had a hands-on approach up until all this came out. And the post office is owned by the government. So, a few more comments. They're all so good. Tom Ricketts has put, what a fine example of weasel words from this woman. Absolutely. I mean, I don't read all these comments, by the way. It's just trying to pick some out, and then I forget, then I re-remember them. I don't always get positive comments or comments about the inquiry. Some people have been quite negative. And sometimes I just think they're trolls because people are actually supporting people like Paula Vennells or anything like that. I mean, how can anyone support a woman like that? How can anyone support Rod Ismay or Janal Singh? Who can support people like Elaine Cotton? The video that I did about her, Elaine Cotton, I said, everyone knows an Elaine Cotton. Everyone knows an area manager who has no idea how the systems work, yet will shout you down, patronise you, or try and blame you for stuff, or put targets on you that are unattainable to try and get rid of you if they don't like you. I've worked in a lot of places with some horrible area managers who know nothing, just like Elaine Cotton. So, that's all the comments for that. That I can get out in a time that's acceptable. There's so many good comments. I'm going to be doing the rest of the Paula Vennells thing all next week and the week after that, because there's about another 10 parts of video that I've got to do. So thank you all for watching and keeping interested in the inquiry. I'm not going to go to the YouTube shorts that I did.
The YouTube shorts, yes.
I'll be able to read all the comments of these because there's not as many. This one was when the ceiling started leaking. Paula Vennells tear ducts can't produce water, but the ceiling ducts in the ceiling can. Aya Charlie watched it all. She got caught on the ropes by Jason Beer on several occasions. Their lies were totally unbelievable. She's a terrible liar, isn't she? And to think she's a vicar. It's just... oh. Catherine Sinclair's put, many people cried because of her. Absolutely. All the tears she's caused, yet she couldn't produce any tears herself. KS has put, so looking forward to your commentary on today's proceedings, Charlie. Yeah, I've had to keep it as captions because I didn't want to make the videos any longer than they already are. I mean, look, editing out all the dead time and then keeping it to a time people can keep watching, it's difficult. Tin Man has put, let her cry some more behind bars. If she went to a proper prison, yeah, but she ain't gonna. Metal Detect in the UK has put, the usual suspects, Sky, BBC, etc. have the headlines of her crying. Probably mission accomplished for her then. Headlines her hijacked and not a single tear in sight. The mainstream media, they all did it, didn't they? Oh, she broke down in tears. This, that, there were no tears. What's happened to the investigative journalism in this country? The UK journalists, all of you, what are you doing? Why is it taking YouTubers to expose these people to see that there's no tears? To see that they're lying? There's nothing. Is it because you're old pals? You know, the government and the media are like that now. So obviously that means the government and the post office are like that. So it's like the circle, the triangle of whatever, isn't it? Sick. You know? What chance have we got? The people who are in power at the moment. And then the people who brought it. Because this is another thing. It's not just a political thing. This is why celebrities and politicians have failed trying to make it a political thing. Because it involves them all. You know, it involves all the spectrum of political. Labour, Liberal, Democrat and Conservative. Because Labour were the ones who insisted that they wanted it to push it in. And it was originally started as to stop people doing benefit fraud. And then Fujitsu bulked up the system to make it cover everything else. It was never intended to do all this. Horizon was never intended to be a do-all system. And then all the celebrities were, I mean, like Ian Hislop and everything. The reason why his words not got out as much is because Private Eye and everything is a more political satire sort of thing, which is usually really more heavily against the Conservatives. But it was Labour that brought it in, this system. They paid for it, they wanted it, and it was rubbish. And then they had it for a while, and then the coalition of Lib Dems and Conservatives came in and just kept on with it. None of them did anything. None of them. So that's why it's not a party thing. It is a government thing. All governments. I mean, all the time they keep saying about, oh, conspiracy theorists, about government and this, that and the other. Well, you just pretty much proved most of them with your shoddy handling of the post office. Sorry, I've skipped ahead now. Yes, UK Davis put, with Sunak announcing he is cutting and running, Vennells will be relieved as she will have even less attention on it. Don't matter, because we're all still angry about it. I think there's loads of people who are still absolutely more interested what's going to happen to the people who caused all this trouble at the post office, more than who's in number 10. Anatoly has put, jail her as soon as possible. Yeah, if she was going to a proper prison. WTO rules has put, post office head gives a first class performance of lying through her teeth. I'm surprised she hasn't got any teeth. She's got any teeth left. With the acid and the crud she was talking, it should have rotted it all away by now. Lying through her teeth, those tears were for herself. There weren't no tears, to be fair, though, was they? She was impressively taken apart by Jason Beer and reps for the core participants. Absolutely. MMQ 07PK has put, why would you buy Kleenex after she has advertised it with her crocodile tears? The dripping on Sir Williams were God's way of saying He did not believe her. Either that or somebody at post office was drilling holes in the roof trying to disrupt the air. I mean, could you put it past post office to actually do that? You know?
Can you imagine?
Ray Collinson has put, Paula Fennell, she gave up her honour from the list. But what poverty, stress, illness, etc., 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 and much more. And she is supposed to be a Christian. I wonder if she has any guilt. My answer on her behalf would be none. But if she wants to help the people, then ask her, would she give her £5 million bonuses back to the public as a gesture of goodwill? You say a lot more, and I'd love to have time to read it all out. It's all amazing comments. I'm glad that we all are still angry about this and call these people out for the rubbish that they're speaking. JLA857 has put, that lady cried at the post office meeting, may have ordered tissues off a shopper channel, or maybe they want the scandal to end. Perhaps she is ill or something else. Yes, I think Kleenex should actually put their word in and say, actually, we don't like our tissues to be on their table, please. We don't mind the Kleenex being on all the other tables, but for the witnesses to the inquiry, for the rest of the inquiry, please remove our tissues from that table, because we do not want their faces touching our merchandise. Frank Gallagher has put, she must have practiced for months in a mirror for that performance. Getting to an acting crouch doesn't wash for me. You can't over rehearse. Back in the day when I wanted to do acting and this, that and the other, you can over rehearse because you can do it so much and so much and so much, and then when you want it, you can't do it. Sound familiar? Paula Vennells. Let's get to the last YouTube shot.
Oh yeah, this is when the audience groaned. It was ridiculous because she'd been banging on about 15 to 20 minutes saying, oh no, I don't take one person's advice. I get my information from all kinds of places.
And, well, not as animated as I've just done it, but she, oh yes, I don't take just any one person's word, when she clearly, on email proof, clearly just took the words off of a media PR person, who is one person. So when she says, I can't recall if I took their advice, everyone just went, oh. And even so when, rightly, I mean, was just like, stop. I mean, because even though the chairman of the inquiry does have to keep the room in check, he still, he could tell. He's just like, yeah, all right, stop everyone. That was in a way of like that. All right, everyone, yeah, I know, I get it. What I'm eating your case, but it says smiling and chuckling are kind of bad. She did smile a lot. A lot of dupers delight going on, didn't she, when she thought she was getting a word across. Very, very strange. And annoying. I'm going to see so much more of it on my channel over the next couple of weeks. Oh, gosh. Has the post office been round? The post office know where I live. Are they trying to kill me? Oh, God, you can imagine that, can't you? You know what I mean? This person called Charles Fleming making YouTube videos about our incompetence. Man, Stu, would they be even competent enough to find me? Would they be even able to find a hitman? What are they going to do, like, lace all my letters? I mean, who gets post anymore? I mean... Lynn from Lynn has put, Sir Wyn clearly understands the anger and frustration from the public gallery. Yeah, hence that's why he's very gentle in his admonitions. Yes, he's an excellent chairman, yeah. Someone did call out from the gallery and Jason Beer told them off because everyone's in high emotional gear in that room because there's going to be people in the public gallery who wear sub-postmasters and this, that and the other. So I'll be quite intrigued to know who shouted out. John Wainwright's put, it's only a matter of time before the audience voiced their disdain. Absolutely. And they did. What I mean, UK's put, and another thing she has been saying, I can't remember today. What do you mean? You might remember tomorrow when facing criminal charges. I noticed that she said that a few times, didn't she? I can't remember that today. It's like, what a weird thing to say. Chairman Alf has put, her disdain look when they groan showed her true character. She did. She did a slow blink and turn away, didn't she? And Michael, this is again. Sorry, I can't pronounce the word. I was trying to read it fast. By that time, people did indeed have enough of her. Mick Munn has put the audience have been very good up to that point. Well, yeah, it's got to be difficult though if you're in that room and you're hearing it like actually in your ear, these lies and these deceiving, trying to deflect. Space Wolf Jr. has put, I love on good authority. I have on good authority that the tissue she used today was a thin slice of cheese. User CK8ZU9TM has put, yeah, I think people are sick and tired of the usual I can't remember shtick, hence the groan from the public gallery. I mean, I groan every time I hear this from the comfort of my lounge chair at home. It doesn't look like she has a box of tissues in front of her. Did she drench them all yesterday? Is that my tissue? This is absolute not something I've just created. I've just thought of it. Look at my tissue. All I do is rub it in my nose and I coughed to it a few times. This is wetter than what air tissue was. These are actually Kleenex. Oh, no, they're not. I think these are the Wilco ones. I've got a bulk load of them when Wilco went bust. But yeah, this tissue, Paula Vennells, is more accurately used than the one you did to flipping wipe your eyes. I can't believe I've just done that. Where am I? Phil Tolkien. That's what this is, the smoking gun, A1 line sentence. Tristram Price, but has anyone figured out how the stenographer could spell that groan? The stenographer. If I can find out who is the stenographer for the inquiry, they need also some sort of reward for having to listen to this drivel, whether it be from Janelle Singh or Rod Ismay and obviously Paula Vennells, where they're constantly just the absolute bilge the talk, having to type that on a stenographer, on a stenography machine, whatever it's called. I tell you, that is skill. I mean, I had respect for the one in the Amber Heard case. You know, the Johnny Depp and Amber Heard thing. The stenographer there, I mean, having to listen to this rubbish and put it down into memoria, whatever it's called. Roy Hayes has put, she's not breeding stock, is she? Charles Evans has put, Bryn has been protecting these bus tarts all the way through. And went on to say, Bryn Williams is a disgrace. I don't know who that is. Bryn? There is no Bryn. The chair is Wyn Williams. And then, yeah, I think this is somebody, maybe a troll or someone's getting completely the wrong end of the stick. There is absolutely no way, you can tell anyway, there's absolutely no way that Wyn Williams is on the side of Paul. Okay? Absolutely not. That was all the comments. Thank you, everyone, for keeping informed of the inquiry. You're all brilliant for paying attention to it, because this is something that we all need to know, what our governments are like, what people high up in companies are like. Thank you all for watching. I want to take my wet tissue and put it in the bin. Officially used tissue, Paul Vennells. And, see you next week. I've got so much work to do. There's so much to do. But I'm going to do it, and you'll see me baggy eyes next Sunday. Thanks for watching. Bye.